A phrase repeated, hypnotized therefore into that non-differentiation. Usually drama is meaningful acts, right? And remember, meaning is always the reinforcing of the given oppressive ideology. So if you believe not in that, but think your only task is to be elsewhere, to act from elsewhere, rather than to continue the circle of acts here in the ideological prison. It's a kind of music that erases the act as meaningful, turning language into a kind of music that erases the act as meaningful. Theatre of non-acts, speech act as non-act also. So just phrases, so just either a non-statement or what arises as a neutral statement, as a neutral inherited repetition of the language you're born into. Not by choice, you're born into it. That language used therefore as a non-do-it, exactly, as a non-do-it, so go ahead and superimpose, go ahead and mismatch, like reaching for a fish in the water when the fish isn't quite there, because the water makes it somewhere else, which opens a gap. A gap is that void which is the self and is the real, that gap which is the void which is the real and is the God in that void. Derision, derision is all the culture is worth, and yet you and I are part of it. Right, and something beyond it is great, right, but can only be indicated in a way that deserves our derision. Yet you're under an obligation to indicate it, and that still deserves our derision. So to those who are serious and try to indicate it, I say bah. But to those jokers who don't even try to indicate the holy, to them I say bah also. Because every sayable is inherited, so it's a bad fit to whatever's real in you. But in that bad fit lies the truth. To be conscious is to say, you have to say. That's what it means to be conscious. To be conscious is therefore to be removed from self and your own experience. To be conscious is to experience nothing but lie. Consciousness is lie. Consciousness is lie. So go ahead and lie, which is a lie, and tell the truth. Which is a lie, so tell the truth, which is a lie, so go ahead and lie, lie, a stream of talk, a lie, one lie on another, one lie on another. Explain it. I'm only happy when I remember to fix on a simple, paradoxically unhappy fact, namely the fact that whatever I say necessarily misses the mark, because I myself don't choose the terms in which I explain what I'm feeling about myself or the world or anything imaginable, since of necessity I use a language forced on me, invented by other people. But when I center, wobble-like, of course, on that insight, only then I feel, I don't know, energized, because a gap bursts open in me, and air, not real air, of course, rushes in and cleanses me, and that's where I want to stay, pivoting on that one idea. Say it again, gladly. What I'm saying is there's a hole in me, in all of us. We have to talk, right? But whatever we say is off the mark. Off the mark. The brain has no pain fibers. Off the mark. Can you explain that I'm only happy when I can key all the time on that one idea? The brain has no pain fibers. You realize I don't have to be anything but a hole in space. That's my only responsibility. I have two choices. Either I'm a mirror or I'm a hole. If I'm a mirror, I reflect back to people something they can name or recognize or think about or have an opinion about. I'm a mirror for their expectations, which all arise out of what they've already experienced. But if I bypass all their expectations, even the expectation of the unexpected, then I'm a void, a hole in their experience, a void. And then only I'm something real instead of a mirror. Get it? A real hole. A hole is real. Bottomless, you could say, which is the closest you can get to it. If it's bottomless, it's real. If it's not, it's a mirror. And it isn't anything at all, really, if it's a mirror. I'd rather be real for some stupid reason. I don't want to be a mirror, thank you. Goodbye. Don't go yet. Say something. Why do I think you're not going to say anything? Well, I should at least give you a chance. Keep an open mind. Once, when I wore my boots, my hair caught on fire. Wow, that was fun.
Do I like trouble? Wow, what a blow to my self-esteem.
Try holding it in.
Why?
Your mouth is your weak part. Your mouth is your weak part. I'm always right. I'm always right.
Enough said, he said, was that me?
I aim at your ideas.
Too bad, I let go.
That's why my aim's so good.
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 Now I see.
Cover one eye.
I'm not supposed to.
Cover one eye.
I'm not supposed to. I'm not supposed to.
No such luck.
I missed that. Good. No such luck. Try again.
I caught up.
Put your head to this if you dare.
Hello to you all. I am here to minister, and I shall. Tears shall flow from your eyes and run river-like beneath my feet, and I shall be supported and sweep toward you through the activity of your own tears. I shall drift into your very hearts. I shall heal you all. Do not ask how, or my power will evaporate. And you do want my power, because you do want my power to work upon you, because you do want my healing. So let your tears flow, flow towards me, that I may have a method for reaching into your very heart. Why cry? The truth is as follows. It can't be said, the truth, which of course renders even that statement questionable. This is my hand. Even that isn't the truth, but it is. But it isn't, because the hand you separate out from the rest of your body and the rest of the world in order to say, here is my hand, can't be separated really, except let me take a somewhat less contestable position than that even. The truth about my inner life can't be told, or yours, or anyone's. I love, I fear, I hate. Such and such an attitude to such and such an object, but
exactly.
Not exactly at all. Whatever words you use to express any of those feelings are words you were born into, words you can choose, all predetermined by the particular language you were born into. Because the test of time and millions of human beings having experience have proved those words useful and exact and correct. No, wait, do be serious and careful for a minute and recognize it isn't true. Here's a picture of someone you love. Meditate on this and upon your feelings, and can you truly say the words, I love you, or whatever subtle and intricate phrases you can come up with. Really express the elusive cloud of shifting things that flicker through you on this or any occasion. I mean, before you give it a name, allow yourself to experience it and then sense whether or not the name really matches with total exactness. Wait a minute, whether or not you agree with me, remember, I'm just answering your question. Why I'm crying? Well, I'm crying because there's no way to express my real feelings with a language that isn't my language. Whether or not you agree, that's why I'm crying. That's expressing yourself. Oh no, it isn't. That's something I've been programmed to do also. Biologically programmed, yes. Well, that biology isn't me, there's something else. I'd go as far as to say not only does all sane err from the mark, even experience misses. By which I mean, you have an experience, but the experience isn't the experience, you see. Something happens. You have an experience. But what you experience that you can feel consciously you experienced is not really what you experienced. That's my feeling about it. I don't have to defend my feelings, I suppose. Other people could have different feelings, but don't you see my point is universally valid? Whatever you experience, even right now, you have no way of registering it to yourself completely as it affects you, which is both as an experience. Ah, you say I'm recognizing I have an experience, but that's on the basis of so many learned assumptions that you just took as they were, stuffed into you because finally you went along with things everybody else said, the way to look at things and experience things and feel things, with one exception.
What exception? My exception. I did escape once. What's wrong?
I've gone up.
What?
I've gone up on my lines.
I thought you were talking from the heart.
Oh, come on. I think this is interesting, but I didn't actually have these thoughts. I memorized something somebody else wrote down, and now I'm blocked.
Stare at that face. Use mental telepathy.
In my private life brought me frustration, nothing major but frustration, and in irritation I threw myself down on my bed with a feeling of giving up. At that moment everything changed, as if a switch had been thrown, the basis of my consciousness changed. It was as if my head were replaced with a glass sphere, perhaps 6 feet in diameter, and everything in the outside world was seen as tiny images on that sphere. But those images projected somehow from the inside, as if their real source was inside me. and this was accompanied by a feeling of joy and light and the sense that everything had been resolved once and for all, and there was nothing but completion and happiness in the world. And this state lasted in me for 20 minutes, and then it began to fade, but for perhaps half an hour, though it had gone, I could remember the feeling. And then I slept, and when I awoke, I could remember that I had had the experience, but could only remember the feeling in the form I could describe to myself in language, but no longer the real feeling as a feeling memory. Well, to me, that moment of paradise was the only experience I've ever had that I trusted that wasn't off the mark. Off the mark. Displaced, but free of that kind of slight mismatch that infects all experience and language and saying and memory as I see it. So that's where my tears come from. And even there, of course, I was crying to make you ask why I was crying. I haven't been able to tell you, or even myself, which is worse, what that singular experience was really like. I've lost it.
You'll just have to keep trying.
Ah, now that's the point. I can keep trying, and I can only try by getting behind my own ideas and words and experiences. That's why you find me hard to understand. I have to trick myself so that I don't get in the way of myself. Understand? I understand you're looking for an excuse for a lot of fuzzy thinking and irrational behavior. Oh no, I'm just trying to live in a world, well, that isn't a fallen world like this world. I'm afraid it's the world you live in. Yes. Yes. But here's the game plan. Category 1. The material world. You live in it. Yes. I live in it. But it's not such a great world the way I look at worlds. Category 2. Forgive me, but Category 2 is the world of the spirit. I have to admit, I can't claim to live in that world of the spirit, if it exists.
There exists shit! I suspect there's a Category 3!
Category 3. Yes, that's the best I can do. If something can flow through me in the right way from these two other places at once, flowing through me, then I'm in Category 3. Welcome to Category 3. We're still in Category 1. Welcome to Category 1. Welcome to Category 1. Get into the gearbox. Get inside the control room. Get into the web. Get into the network itself. Get inside the circuit. Tacky but considerable. Tacky but considerable. Here it is, a piece of the truth balanced against the whole truth. Which is heavier? You'll get a real surprise. A real surprise.
Shake my hand, I stop breathing!
I see sparks fly!
What?
Now
The secret of things is to find category three. There is first logic of things coming out of other things, a logical connection, be that cause and effect, or determined by categories or logical types or motivational source, etc. Things like that, etc. Then there is category two, random nonsense, nonsense, chance, random relations, all those kind of relations or non-relations, whatever you choose to call them. But category three is something that eludes both category one and two. Most people viewing it superficially mistake category three for category two, that is, randomness and chance. But the items of category three, though not connected, are in fact connected, but in a way that is not perceivable within our available grids. So it's taken on faith, as it were. But as somebody said, it moves mountains. It's that door to another world that is located in that other world. Go through it, but it's not in this world. So category three eludes logic. Yet it is not random or chance-like, but it is a connective tissue that cannot be traced, and yet is the one truly lively way of perceiving the world. It lays down the ground of the real being alive, where the other two categories, logic and chance, are predictable in their emotional kick. And don't kid yourself, that's the only lust that moves you, that lust for the emotional kick. So do you want a new one? Or an old one, a new emotional kick, or an old one? What lays down the grid of real, alive, living is category three. Category three is the only real source. This category three, which is a door that isn't openable from this side, but it opens. One must enter to be alive. Only category three, which one enters from death's side only, into life. It is a category which people will call unnatural and irrational, but it isn't. It falls between the cracks of the normal rationale. It is the ultimate fruitful location, those cracks in reality which nurture, because they are not reality, which is not alive, but seen through the perceiving mechanism, which means not touched really, just messages coming from far away through a very defective system ruled by fear and habit. So one should want always to be in that nurturing ground, which is category three. Welcome to category three. Should I observe myself breathing in and out here in category three? Try it, but don't let it being distracted get you distracted. Welcome to category three. Welcome to category three. Welcome to category three. Shall I feel love and attraction to other human beings here in category three? Why not? Why not? What I mean is, try it. Oh, you just made the wrong move. I didn't move anything. Welcome to category three. Welcome to category three. Welcome to category three.
Us here at the Bratwurst with a potato in his mouth.
Somebody back into a high energy field. Please make
I discovered something.
Effort.
A straight line right into the brain.
Turn a corner. Turn another corner. Somebody back into a high
Let
energy
me get a handle
field.
On this. This is going straight past
Please
me, effectively non-stop. You better move fast.
I want it.
Door inside to get inside. You opened the door outside to get outside. I don't know how, but you did it. I didn't know I did it, but you did it. Plenty of people give up on balance. The whole system went down the drain. Was I part of the system? Much to my surprise, yes, comes up. Play with it? Why not? I'm a hell of a guy when the right ball comes rolling into my part of the landscape. Go to a good school. Go to your apartment. Go to the highest place in France. go to the Chinese laundries after deciding to have a good meal, go to bed sometimes, go to the country estate, go to the waterfront but exercise, go to a garage, go to a farm, but first, go to a farm, go to earth, go to shortwave, hello, go to the meaning, go to an encyclopedia. How is the language machine working? Tell me, how is the language machine working? Is the language machine working good? Tell me about it. Tell me about it. The language machine is working. How many words is the language machine turning out each day? Each day, two or three words. The language machine is not working good. No, the language machine is working good. Is there a difference of opinion as to whether the language machine is working good? Is there a difference of opinion as to whether the language machine is working good? Is the language machine working good? Good. Is there a difference of opinion as to whether the language machine is working good? Good. Is there a difference of opinion as to whether the language machine is working good? Is the language machine working good?
This is a dance I did in the privacy of my biggest adventure.
It went good?
Good was a no-no word.
When?
Is there a difference of opinion as to whether the language machine is working good? Good. Chocolate pies. Here are some chocolate pies. Here are some beautiful chocolate pies. Here are some chocolate pies. Yum. Surprise. There's something to touch, but there's nothing to lick. I can still say, chocolate pies, eyes, pies, eyes. Now let's find them, those pies. He tries and he tries to find those pies. Is there an energy field around chocolate pies that is some kind of energy other than a chocolate derivative? Look, you were the one who imagined it. Those pies are real, Buster. Two eyes don't prove it, pies prove it. You got pies because you make it happen through your eyes. Then how come I also put up the issue of an energy field? Chocolate pies. Whoever tries to eat really gets shook up inside. So calm chocolate is something to psych out. Psych out. Speak to the world in pie form. Pie in the sky form. Chocolate pie. Chocolate pie.
Whenever I feel bad, I let 100 words come fast without thinking.
Whenever I feel bad, I make up a lie until it's gone.
Repeat that.
Too late, Tom.
Repeat that.
Too late, Tom.
Whenever I feel bad.
When I talk, it hurts my extremities. Hello, I've replaced myself with a radio. 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 Oh, I tripped over a word, and perhaps that was when the word death entered. Solutions to all my problems are forthcoming. Oh, I tripped over a word, and perhaps that was when the word death entered. Solutions to all my problems are forthcoming. E-piano is in my heart. 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 My bag of tricks is extensive. You notice that my interpretation of reality is reality. You notice that my interpretation of reality is reality. The conventional memory stopped working. The conventional memory stopped working. The conventional memory stopped working. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, get so deep into this book that reading it sends arrows into the brain? Who can make reading tears? Who can punch his eyes by looking at himself? Who can change that much? I realize that the change issue is the inside issue, but it's an outside issue. Suppose I put on a heretofore funny hat, and it wasn't funny. You know why? Because something different is at work in me. I can name it, but it doesn't have to have a name to be first rate. Welcome to Category 3. Welcome. You've heard about Category 3? Not logic, not irrational, accident or chance. Something else, a crack, a twist in the very obvious thing in front of my nose, maybe even the nose. Yourself. Or am I wrong? Do feet, in fact, get you away from your own self? I don't think so.
That doesn't interest me. Only if you suppress a certain particular series of thoughts that come flooding somehow through the brain.
Thank goodness I never experienced that.
How come you haven't picked up on Category 3? Category 3 is in well-formed.
Category 3. Am I moving from the spot? I am not. Now I was not in Category 3, and now I am, not having left it. You join me without knowing it. Welcome to Category 3. Say yes. Welcome to Category 3. Yes, I was talking to myself.
God, you just left Category 3. Unfortunately.
I don't think I ever understand.
Here's an experiment. Try touching your nose. Now, find a way to hold onto your nose with the major part of your hand. Now breathe through the nose.
Ah, that's music to my ears.
Yes, but it's really Category 3. Category 3.
Of course not. I've been manipulating you for no good reason, just like that. Show me your hair. Of course. Did you make that request just pop out of my unconscious? Somebody did. Now I'm into my own time frame and I like it, sort of. I'm going to support my body. Yes, do that all the time. I'll have to develop my back muscles. Please do. Please do. Please do. Please do. I can't say what I'm hoping for. Back muscles that become so excessive, everything is beyond imagining, to say the least, which is to say nothing. But we do go that far. Am I growing a letter or two coming out from my back?
I'm waiting here with pen and pen.
As soon as you see one of the letters rising from the back muscles,
I'll write down whatever I see.
Somebody knocked. Somebody fell down. Somebody said, hello, hello, but they weren't talking to me. No, they were. Somebody telephoned. Somebody tried capturing my attention. Help, I offered. Somebody imitated me. Somebody attacked me, but I was on vacation. Somebody felt bad. Somebody smiled. Why, I wondered. I didn't know it was involuntary. I expected it to turn into a face, but it didn't. I forgot about it. I forgot about it. In this city, capital of thought, illness is permitted, and verbal behavior is by definition what leaves something out. Entrapment, the name of the game. The statements made are the statements in which you fill in, inevitably, certain blanks. Then revealed naked as you really are, the verbal police close in for the kill. Say, why did you join the verbal police? How could you? How could you do that? The answer is, I like power sometimes. And having said that, everybody looks at me in a different light. Oh, now I get it, they say. He's out for kicks. That I can understand. I think to myself, you don't know what you reveal about yourself when you say, I'm out for kicks. Do I write you up? Of course I do. But you never know whether it's punishment or gratification, so I'm as mysterious as ever in your eyes. That's what it's like being part of the verbal police.
City of language intrigue. Easy to meet people who all seem to be using the same words over and over, when really each time it's a blow to a different part of the body.
The telephone is for you. I'm being challenged to respond, but I defiantly seal my lips. Having done that, I'm ready to handle the receiver. It wasn't for you after all. I'm not fooled. I make of things whatever I choose. You, of course, would maintain that in your way you're doing much the same. But the difference is I have at my command not your guttural virtuosity, and therefore lack your nothing but pure pre-word noise network. I simply use statement in the most perverse way possible, and thereby end up far outdoing even your spectacular physical methods with my private syntactical articulations. They'd like you to pick up your end of that conversation. What do you know, verbal police? You? Did you think I was pretending you were a mirror? I am, you know. That's why I have myself reflected. Thank God I can see who I am whenever I run into you fellas.
Are you enjoying Marvel by the Eminent Writer?
Richard Foreman.
You proved it, I think. The verbal police are watching. So proof was an act of desperation in this case. Does that count? Stoics also count. Up to three, which is proved. But that achieved, limitless numbers are also assumed inside the numerological grid that suddenly snaps into conscious presence. A magic square in the mind. No, the minute the verbal police stake out their claim, all that mind stuff is persona non grata mind, and the language game turns into the only town anybody can live in. Did you say live? Did you say open a door? I said find out where you live, because this is where you do live. But I don't know if that's what you want to call it, since accuracy is something a little bit slippery. Like ice on glasses, like butter on sharp steel, on stone, on marble, iron, wood, tin, paper, gold, plastic, wood, gold. Gold. Gold.
I give you what you don't want.
Unless I get the better I like it.
That's so.
That's not me speaking.
I turn myself inside out.
Don't ask.
I didn't eat it.
Inside out.
Ask.
Don't ask.
Don't raise that.
I do mental juggling.
Dropping things.
Everything. Almost everything.
Break something. Materials, that's how deep my dream goes, and it goes deep. The spirit of things seemed to be floating about for just anyone to catch, because the material is swamping all those who do get swamped. The substance delineation is rolling over me like a wave of sudden understanding, and I think that substance inside you just needs me, frankly, to get my hands in there to do a sort of manipulation which to outsiders is going to look like mental massage. That excites me. But not enough. When you say excited, you're still traveling in the realm of the self-contained. Could I count on you for anything but a series of premises that pan out to nothing? through my producers pan out, because when you read something as thin as one's thin a sheet of any unusually valuable substance, that mental cornucopia can pour out over a whole world that has its own secret name, and the name is itself. Itself? Do you recognize that name, I'm sure, hidden in some of your favorite evocative nouns? Like wood, glue, iron, flesh, brain, steel, metal, gold, fabric, flesh, gold. Those words almost turn to round for me. Those aren't words. They don't function like words because you put out your hand and groped toward the wrong real thing. The way out? Too late. Too late. I'll make a fast exit. Open. Open the door. No more. Open. No door. There is no door. There is no door. I don't see a door. Sure, there is. The door out is outside. The door in is inside. Am I outside or inside? You want to get out or in? I want to get out. That's where the door is. I want to get in. Ah, that's where the door is. I don't see no door. I don't see no door. I don't see no door.
Doctors of death on the rampage again, spreading their violence wherever they can. Poison that punishes, poison that kills. Really the medicine, cure for your ills. Soundness on soundness, wild under the sky. Only escape is escape if you try. Methods that promise to help and they don't. Lift yourself right into will through a won't.
Tell me, has one of us been... Has one of us been practicing our balancing act?
Waiting for answers is like waiting for a heart attack. Sentiment is evoked, but isn't the heart of the matter, in a sense. Soon did he throw a hat in the air. Soon, one word that's all words. Soon did a flutter turn automatic. Soon, when a bar of chocolate and a bar of soap were interchangeable, what got the bubble burst? And soon, the place it fell to was uncomfortable delight. So roll, twist the matter behind the mind, so the green irritant oyster goes snap at the brain spark that lights up my whole world at least. Roll one word, that's all words. Roll like got an ocean in my ocean. Space out, phases, phase. Don't get lost eating your basis. It goes out in a big circle, loops back and says the triple dip. Dips me, you, and everybody in good stuff. When I say stuff, I say stuff, more stuff. Phase it. Veronica came into my life like a cyclone of plastic. Who got off first? Hard to say, but when I got down from the talk lock bus, boy was I hot. Phase it. One word, that's all words. Phase it. That means cool out the whole planet. Airedale and more. My holes to vent. Blocked up by the information. That wasn't Veronica's trip. So my return ticket stuck up. Tickled me. And I couldn't phase it. So instead I phase it. Phase it all the time. Phase it. These must be bad arrows, or I must have had bad aim. or I must be better at this than I ever imagined possible. Who's the big guy? Who's the big guy? He doesn't say much, but he doesn't have to, because the minute he starts talking, you know he's half right and half wrong anyway, which is more than I can say about myself. Whoops, I just did. Whoops, one word, that's all words. Who's the big guy? I thought he lived in my neighborhood, but now I see this town has particular features that turn it into a very recognizable and unrecognizable part of town, to say the least, which is why I like it. Who's the big guy? Who's the big guy? I don't know. You don't know. He doesn't know himself, but that isn't a negation. All he does is open his big mouth wide. Without saying it, I know I'm home free. I am home free. Welcome to Category 3. Welcome. Welcome to Category 3. Welcome to Category 3. To Category 3. Welcome. Welcome to Category 3.